You may know your ABCs, but do you know your QTC? Well, OMG, you need to know your QTC. Why? Because it can save your life. It's all about the mechanics of your heart. When your heart goes thump, 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 it's because there's an electrical pulse going whoosh, whoosh, whoosh. It shows up on an EKG, creating a QRS. Lots of medical jargon. Okay, let me explain. Your heartbeat is measured with markers, Q, R, S, and T. From the start of that whoosh is the beginning of that Q. Then a quick R and S. And then before it goes whoosh, there's that T. Don't worry, a machine known as an EKG will measure all of this for you. There are home options, so you may not need to go in and see the doctor. The important thing to know is that your QTC cannot be too slow. As the interval gets too long, it can create some serious harm. If your QTC is less than 440 ms, that's milliseconds, then you are good to go, green light. But if your QTC is between 440 ms and 460 ms if you are a man, and 470 ms if you are a woman, then you are at a higher risk, yellow. If it is above 460 for men and 470 for women, then you need to stop and ask your doctor because you are at a greater risk, red. You see, your heart needs to go thump, thump, thump in a steady rate. And the longer your QTC, it can trigger some dangerous electrical patterns.
Hi, this is Dr. Bradley. There are certain things that can increase your QTC, to include certain medications. One of those medications is chloroquine or hydroxychloroquine. There is specific guidance from the American College of Cardiology for healthcare providers on what to do to assess the risk with a red light recommendation at 480 ms. They have specific actions that can be taken to reduce that risk. So, know your QTC like you know your ABCs. Before you take medications like chloroquine or hydroxychloroquine, talk to your provider.